Okay. Hey, how's it going? Hope you're doing well. Welcome to my nitrating video. In this video, you'd realize that I typically have very full and long days, and my nitrating typically starts from here. Whether it's a weekday or a weekend, I'm usually in this room either shooting a video or editing towards the evening time. And then once I realize it's time to start the nitrating, then I go out and get started with whatever it is that I have to do. So as you would see in this video, I have very, very long and full days such that by the time my night routine comes along, I'm tired, I'm exhausted. But one thing I always look forward to is getting into bed at night. And that is because the Shut Eye app makes getting into bed something to look forward to. The Shut Eye app is an all-in-one sleep app that provides a variety of sleep sounds and stories that can help you fall asleep at night. You know, it also has a sleep tracker to monitor your sleep quality, and then it has a tracker that monitors your sleep cycle as well, and you know, a recording function if you want to record snoring sounds, or maybe like me, sometimes you catch yourself sleep talking and you want to record that. The Shut Eye app does that for you as well. However, I specifically use the sleep tracker function in order to monitor my sleep quality and cycle. You know, as a working mom, I go through such busy days that sometimes I get so overwhelmed and I'm losing sleep and I'm not getting enough sleep. But with the sleep tracker function or the Shut Eye app, I'm able to track my sleep, monitor my sleep cycle, so that I ensure that I keep track of how I'm sleeping and that I am getting enough hours of sleep every night. If you're not sure if it's something for you, then I encourage you at least download the Shut Eye app for free. You know, you can use the free version just to test and see what it's all about. But I encourage you subscribing for the premium features, because then you get the most benefits from the app. Some of us need extra assists, you know, to get that minimum number of hours that we should sleep, okay? And Shut Eye does that. All right, so now let's get into the routine proper. Let me introduce you. All right, so my night routine typically starts at about 4:30, 5 p.m. ish, and that's about the time that Mimi needs to have a snack. It can range from biscuits to yogurt to some fruits, some chicken, just whatever I decide to give him at that time. Today, I decided to give him Ribena with some biscuits as well, just to snack on. I come to think of it, we're out of that Ribena. Okay, I need to get another one because he really does like it. So I just make sure to dilute it well and then give him some biscuits to snack on, because he's still going to eat dinner, you know, and I don't want him to be too full. And yeah, I like to place him on his high chair whenever he wants to feed himself, because that's the only way it's going to work. And typically also I don't let him watch TV whilst he's eating. However, on days where I really need to get a lot of work done or I'm trying to do other things, I let him, so that way I don't have to like worry about entertaining him or anything like that. He was watching, I guess that's Cocomelon, right? He was just eating and watching, and that gave me time to go into the kitchen and get cleaning. This is what the kitchen looks like right now, and it's because I cooked earlier today. So I did like stew and everything, and it was a Sunday evening, so it was just kind of like a lot of things, like look at all that mess everywhere. So I knew, okay, I needed to start cleaning and putting things away, and that was what I started doing whilst Nimi was eating his snack. And I also made some chicken as well. So as you can see, it was a busy day for me. Yeah, so I just kind of got started with putting the chicken away. Typically, I use this Ziploc bag to put them away in the refrigerator. And then after that, I pack everything up, you know, trash whatever it is that I need to trash. And then after that, I got to, oh yeah, you know, put everything away in the fridge like it should go. And once I was done with that, then I started cleaning, you know, because you have to put plates away, just kind of like clearing up everything that needed to be cleared up, because I needed the kitchen to go back to how it normally looked. That's how I like it. So I probably spent about an hour just trying to put the kitchen back together again, trying to make it look good, look clean, and all of that. And yeah, it does take some time trying to do that. And once I was done, I also had to put the stew that I cooked, put it away. So typically I don't put pots inside the fridge. I do not. In the past I used to, but not anymore. No matter what I cook, I must empty it into a Ziploc bag, into a bowl, to go pack something. It must be entered into something, and then it will go inside the fridge, and then I make sure to wash the pots right away. And that's exactly what I'm doing here. So I packed the stew, packed the rice, and then put them away in the fridge and go washing the dishes, because that way, you know, everything just feels better organized and all of that. Okay, so once I was done cleaning, I'm not done washing the dishes there, but Mimi wasn't eating, and typically when he's done, I like to clear the table before he starts to drum and scatter the entire place. So I got to cleaning, and I always clean the stove, the electric stove, every night before I go to bed, because especially on days when I cooked heavily, you know, just to make sure I get all the dirt out. I clean the stove, I clean the microwave, I clean the countertops, I clean everywhere. I love it when it's, especially on a Sunday night again, you know, you want to start Monday and start with, you know, clean house, feeling refreshed and all of that. So I always clean everything. I clean the fridge as well, like the stainless steel of the fridge, and look at that, sparkling clean. And then I got to washing the dishes, you know, that were left in the sink from earlier, you know. So we got to keep moving, putting things away, washing things, just trying to move it along. Once I was done with cleaning the dishes and the sink and the countertops, then I swept, you know. I mean, I feel like cleaning is not complete without sweeping the kitchen. And typically I might use the vacuum if I'm trying to do like a deep cleaning, but on a day where I'm just trying to gather the dirt and just put them away, I just use the broom, because that way it's much faster for me. So once I'm done with that, I wash my hands, because very, very important. Okay, and then today was a Sunday, so I had to fold the clothes that we had washed. So typically I do laundry on Saturday night going into Sunday morning, and then by Sunday afternoon and evening I fold all the clothes. So that's what I'm doing here. At this point I believe I had already folded the colored clothes, and I was about to fold the whites, because of course naturally you wash both sets separately, so the colored always takes longer to fold actually. So I was just like, okay, I'll do the whites later, and that's what I'm doing now. Yeah, that mat that you see, the laundry mat that you just saw in the laundry room, it was a gift from a very dear auntie of ours. Shout out to you, Auntie June. Thank you so much for loving us. I love that mat. It just kind of adds a vibe to the laundry room that I like. So yeah, at this point, Mimi is still watching TV and I am rushing to fold the clothes because I know that he's going to get tired of sitting very soon and I'll need to put him down. But if I put him down whilst folding the clothes, I would not get it done because it will scatter everywhere for me. So once I'm done folding the clothes, I let him down off of his high chair. Those things you see on his arms are braces to keep him from sucking his fingers. You know, we were really trying hard to keep him from sucking his fingers. God help us. So yeah, put him down and you're going to see him running around now. Like, he's like, yay, freedom. I love him. Look at him. Do you see what I'm saying? Like, he gets signs, starts to follow me everywhere. At this point, I had, you know, done the chores I needed to do. I was like, okay, now I'm going to start editing and also responding to messages or comments on the channel. So I love to keep up with the comments. I know it's very difficult. I don't try to respond to everyone, but you know, I try my best to get to as much as I can. And on days like this, that's what I start to do first. I go to the comment section and I just respond to whatever comments are tops, like I can see, or maybe someone has asked a specific question or something, and I'm able to do that because, see, I've turned off the TV as well because he had had enough TV for the day and it was time for him to play. Totin was back at this point. I don't know if I mentioned it earlier, but he went to the store to buy us some groceries, you know, which he always does. And he was back and he had them over there. So yeah, whilst I was still trying to edit and stuff, they were playing together. Justin was just kind of playing with him, trying to, you know, spend some time with him. And then when he was all kind of done playing with me, he decided to help to put away the groceries as well. At this point, I was still editing the video I was working on. So when I decided to take a break from the video, I decided to make some biscuits for us. All three of us love those biscuits. They are the Pillsbury biscuits. We typically get it from the store. You just kind of pop it in the oven for like 10 minutes and then it's ready. And I just like it. Nimi likes it. Tosin likes it as well. So we always buy it and it's quite easy to make. So I made that. And by this time, it was already, like you can see the clock behind me, it was already about a few minutes to 7, meaning it was time for Nimi's dinner. So what I do is to, I decided to feed him rice and ewedu. I know some people are going nuts, like, what combination is that? Tell me if you have ever tried it for your baby. Nimi absolutely loves it. I just decided to try it for him one day and he liked it because he likes ewedu and then he likes rice, but I didn't like how the rice was always kind of like dry, you know. And so I decided to mix the two and he loved it. Okay, he never says no to it. And I always make sure that ewedu has either fish or chicken. You've seen me cook it, so you know how I cook it. And there he is, just eating. And I was trying to sing to him and playing with him because he was hungry and ready to eat at this point. So yeah. But he loves it. Let me know if it's a combination, if you think it's crazy or if it's something you probably would try. Let me know in the comments, okay? But he loves it and so we're good. Alright, so once I'm done feeding him, I go back into the kitchen and I put away all the dishes that I washed earlier, like the pots, the dishes, everything. Just kind of put them away. And then also do the little plates and spoon that I just used to feed Nimi. Now when I'm done with that, I go inside the room to get Nimi ready for bed, and also get the room ready for bed for us to sleep. So typically I lay the bed in the mornings. It's very strange that on this particular night the bed wasn't laid, but yeah, I always lay the bed in the mornings, but some days, you know, we just kind of sleep on it during the day and it ends up like that, so that's why it's messy. But I was ironing Nimi's clothes here. I typically pick out what you wear to school or to daycare the next day. I pick it out at night and I had to iron that, so that was what I did there. And now I'm laying the bed because once Nimi goes to bed, you know, I turn out the lights and he has to sleep first before we go inside the room, and that way he doesn't start crying that we should pick him up and everything. So I like to make sure the bed is ready for us and we can just sneak in and sleep, so that's why I'm doing that. So once I'm done with that, I set his humidifier, put it close to his crib so that, you know, he can use it. I also set the things he will use for his bath and get him ready for bed. Once he has his bath, he goes straight to bed, like he goes to sleep. His day is over. So yeah, I gave him his bath here, and once I was done, he went to bed, and then it was time for me. As you can see on my face, I was knackered. I was exhausted. I'm even exhausted watching this back because I don't even know how I did all of that. But I was tired. I'm sorry I'm frowning here. I was just tired. I didn't even know I was frowning until I started editing. Anyway, so I spent some time alone, you know, taking care of myself, take off my makeup. I used the Micellar cleansing water to remove my makeup. It works pretty well, actually. He just breaks it down easily, I guess. I don't know, I might still try other things, but that's what I use. I also take out my contact lenses if I wore contacts that day, which I typically do on Sundays. I take it out, put it away, and then I take my bath as well. Can you notice that I haven't eaten? Like, are you wondering, won't you eat? I didn't care. But I'll eat, we'll get there. So I just get ready, have my bath. Once I'm done with my bath, I do like my quick skincare routine. On this particular night, I decided to do my regular skincare routine, nothing too deep, which consisted of The Ordinary and the moisturizer as well, and that was it. Just I was too tired to do anything more than that. And then, you know, spray some, smell good, spray some things all over the body, mist, good stuff. So once I was done, it was time to go continue editing, and that's typically what I do. By this time it's usually like 8 p.m. And so on this particular night, I decided to have pizza for dinner because I had the video I was editing, I wasn't done with it. It was still a long way to go, and I wanted to, you know, maximize the time that I had. So I had pizza and some juice for dinner, and I'd set my Shut Eye app, you know, to notify me when it was time for bed and to track my sleep as well. And yeah, that's the pizza that I'm eating, and I'll just set my computer now and get editing. That's what I do at this point. Tosin is probably also working or watching TV or almost always working. If he's watching TV, he has slept because he falls asleep so fast. But yeah, so that's what my night routine as a mom of one is like, as a working mom of one. Living in Houston, Texas, what do you think? What can you relate with? What can you not relate with? I want to know. Thank you so much for watching. I pray God blesses you, your homes, your marriages, your relationships. Most importantly, I pray God blesses you. Meaning God, and God bless you. Bye.